What's good, bro? This is Jim with SeductionLeash.com, and I'm about to show you the 3 hacks to help get any girl to text you back instantly. Now, before I waste any time, I just want to make this clear. This shit is not a miracle worker. It's not going to sweep a girl off your feet if she does not like you at all. But if you need a if you're in a situation where you need a girl to text you back, this is it right here. If these 3 things don't work, then she either got hit by a fucking bus or she just really don't fuck with you. Number 1, text her name back with some dramatic dots. The dramatic dots are very important. Okay, it's not really that important, but it adds that little bit of drama. And every bitch, the favorite word in the universe is their own name. I mean, to be fair, that's basically like all us humans. You know, we like hearing our name. If you text a girl her name, like say her name's Helena or some shit, say you text Helena with 2 dots, she's gonna text you back. She's just gonna wanna know, like, what the fuck, like, what's going on? You say her name. I mean, it's hard not to text that. If some random number texted your name right now, you would probably reply like, oh yeah, what happened, who is this? There you go. There, you can take it from there. From that point on, it's all you, boy. A lot of us, you know, we get to the point where we're like, man, I gotta text something witty or clever or whatever the kid. Yo, when I'm just fucking lazy, I just text a girl her name and then 2 dots if I want to add some drama. She's gonna reply. She's gonna be like, what happened? And then I could just take it from there. I just want the attention. But a lot of times, in order to get a girl's attention, if we write too much shit or we try to be too witty, we're basically validating them before they even replied, before they even said anything. But at the same time, if you just like, hey, what's up? You just sound like every other fucking dude. So it's like this kind of middle ground. And just saying their name kind of hits that middle ground. By the way, bro, if it's your first time here and you're interested in dating, relationships, self-improvement, and motivational content, start now by hitting that button right there so you can join that Elite notification gang, bro, so you don't miss anything. So with that being said, let's get back to the video. Number 2, this is another bread and butter favorite of mine, which is to type guess what with the question mark or dots. Doesn't really fucking matter. I'm not here to microanalyze, but if you type guess what, it's gonna be very hard for a chick not to reply. The only thing is, obviously, is you need to follow it up with something. Now, maybe it's this chick I'm fucking with for a while, I might say something more flattering, like, guess what? I just saw you in a dream right now. And maybe I might tease them at the end of that and say you were wearing some goofy shit or some shit. If not that, if I'm not that cool with the chick and I don't want to validate her that much, I might just say something like, I saw a girl today that looked exactly like you. And at that point, she's probably gonna ask like, oh, where were you? Maybe you did see me, or maybe I was out and about. That could lead to logistics and other shit that can help. So if you're looking for what to follow it up with, I'm telling you, bro, you need to have a game plan. This video is just to help you get in the fucking door. And this right here, this has worked for me time and time and time again. Back in the day, you know, I used to say a lot more goofy shit. I used to just test and experiment a lot more. Now, I don't have that much of a tolerance, and I just stick with what works. But back in the day, I used to text shit like, hey, I just had a wet dream about you. Yeah, you fell off a cliff and I pissed myself laughing. Stupid shit like that. Sometimes it works, sometimes it not, but usually I just keep, less is more. Ultimately, a lot of times, less is more. We try to be too witty, or if we try to be too generic, that kind of kills it too. It's just enough to add that little middle ground, that neutrality, with it's just out of reach. You know what I mean? You're giving them the validation, you're saying their name, you're saying guess what, but you're not quite saying, hey, what's up, hey, I was just wondering about you. Or you're not doing any of that shit. You're not giving them that validation, and at the same time, you're not being boring as fuck to get their attention. Number 3, this is more of a bonus tip. This isn't so much to get a bitch's attention if you don't have anything established yet. This is more so for a girl that you're already talking to. Maybe the first 3 months you're flirting, or you've been seeing each other for a little bit. This right here is just, it adds that drama, which is to basically say to her, can I be honest with you for a second? This is kind of like a false takeaway, because by saying this, it just, again, it adds drama. It's basically, it sounds like something, it almost sounds like something a girl would say to a guy before she breaks up. Now, normally bitches will say shit like, we need to talk, okay? Now, they're not that nuanced. But if you say, can I be honest with you for a second, it comes across very judging, like you're trying to bestow upon them some shit that you've been meaning to say, but you didn't want to say because it might just hurt their feelings, or not. It could be whatever. And that's the point. You say that shit, you play it up, you add a lot of drama, and you play up. I'm not gonna lie, I used to fuck with chicks. I used to literally tell bitches, like, I'm moving. Like, right when they just start talking to me, it's peaking real hard, I'd be like, can I be honest with you for a second? I'm actually moving. and then I would say someplace way too fucking far for them to reach, and it would be hilarious. A lot of times I would say, like, oh, let's meet up one last time for a dramatic goodbye, and a lot of times they would not want to do it. They'd be like, what's the point? You're fucking leaving anyways. Yeah, whatever, bitch. It's fucking hilarious. It's like one of my favorite things to do is to put girls in that area of like nervousness, because that's the area that we always, that we tend to always lie in, especially with the hunters. Wait, we're waiting to see if they like us, if they had an orgasm, if they this, if they that. This time you put them in those shoes, and I can't lie. I must be a little bit sadistic because I enjoy it. Or is it Matt? Yeah, it's not Matt sadistic. Yeah, it's kind of sadist. It's kind of fucked up and hilarious. So try it out. So if you enjoyed that kick-ass, dope, incredibly poppy video and you want to see more on daily relationships, self-improvement, and motivational content, start now by hitting that button right there so you can join that Unleash notification game, bro, so you don't miss anything. So with that being said, unleash your best, and remember, until next time, confidence is bred by confidence. Peace.